Governor Walz also spent the day marking the 9/11 anniversary.
He was here in Minnesota taking part in a day of service, packing meals in St. Paul with hundreds of volunteers. John Croman caught up with the governor and he joins us now.
Well, this notion of volunteering for service projects on 9/11 was started by survivors and the families of victims, and it takes many forms across the nation. The one that Governor Walz attended is something that also answers a rising need.
A day to pause and remember, and a day to think of how you can get involved in your community.
Hundreds of volunteers gathered in Roy Wilkins Auditorium in St. Paul to pack meals as part of a 9/11 Day of Service event for Cross Services Food Shelf and Second Harvest Heartland.
Food insecurity in Minnesota continues to rise, so events like this are critical, especially, you know, the holiday season is right around the corner, so we think of the extra budget strain on families in the community. This is coming at a great time.
109. At 100 for 106 days in a row.
Among the meal packers, Governor Tim Walz, just back from a vice presidential campaign swing in Arizona. He thanked volunteers for spending part of their day helping feed people. Minutes earlier, he spoke to the whole room about the significance of public service on 9/11.
It may have not lasted as long as we'd have liked, but there was a moment of unity around shared values. There was a moment of unity about caring for one another.
We also heard from Cindy McGinty, a 9/11 Day board member from Massachusetts. Her husband, Mike, was killed in the North Tower of the World Trade Center on 9/11.
The terrorists thought they could tear us apart, but what they really did was they brought us together. And that's what 9/11 is really about.
The goal for the AmeriCorps volunteers and others who filled this auditorium was to pack 230,000 instant breakfast meals to honor the legacy of those who were lost on that tragic day and to keep food shelves full.
It is a real need. We know in Minnesota that families are struggling, and so to come together like this and support organizations like Second Harvest Heartland, it's a really incredible thing to do.
Now, normally at an event like this, the governor could stroll over and chat with the local media, but now that he's the vice presidential candidate, there's this Secret Service protocol that kind of keeps us from getting very close to him. So that's why you didn't see more from the governor today. Back to you.
All right. Times are changing. John, thank you.